Hello, I'm Pretty Hood H, and we are live and direct at the Hub with Cashh.
Yo, yo, yo. Well, go on.
How are you?
Blessed, and I'm highly favoured. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Everything good?
Yeah, everything blessed.
Good, good, good. You're really tall.
Yeah.
I know I said that before, but I didn't expect you to be that tall. How tall are you?
6 foot plus. Just for the whole of them know, just in case them think I was a short man.
6 foot plus, yeah. Okay, listen, I'm about to make a statement right now.
Go ahead.
Yeah, you ready? You ready? Yeah. Ladies love Cashh, you know?
Do they?
Let me tell you something, yeah. You see my friends, my core group, yeah? They don't really listen to rap like me, innit, yeah? But you see you. They know about Cashh, you know?
Nah, big them up, man.
Hey! Do you get that a lot with the ladies and stuff? Really?
Not really, man.
Oh, how my lot go on? My God, I thought you, like, you know what I mean? The DMs and that, no?
Nah, my DMs, tumbleweed.
Really?
Empty in there.
Oh, wow. Okay. So, Cashh, we are going to be talking about you coming back to the scene in 2019.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? How did it feel to come back?
Well,
stepping off that plane.
When I returned, it was it was a grateful feeling.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I knew it was a blessing for me to be able to get another opportunity like this.
Yeah.
Not just career-wise, but even in terms of family. Mm-hmm. You understand? Like, so it was just good to be able to travel again.
Yeah.
And just be amongst my people then.
How about the weather? You know, you
the weather, I really didn't mind. Like,
okay.
There were times when I was in Jamaica and I was hot and just wanted to feel a little bit of cold.
Right.
So I yearned to feel it, asked the man them. When I felt like more time they got jackets on, I'd have a t-shirt. Not now. Now it's different.
Now you
but they're long enough, you've been 5 cents.
Yeah.
But when we first reach,
I
just wanted to feel the cold.
Okay, okay. Well, welcome back. I know it's been a while, but I'm telling you, welcome back, innit? You know what I mean? So I want to know, what was it like being deported so publicly? Like, you know, because it was quite viral. Like, I even remember that. Do you know what I mean? What was it like you having to deal with that?
I feel like, I don't know. I feel like, because there wasn't any other choice but to go public at that.
Mm-hmm.
For me, there wasn't really much. It's just like, you just have to do what you have to do. You know what I mean?
Yeah. But it was quite new for everyone as
Yeah, so even that, it's like, I could have got back to Jamaica and no one would have known anything. Like, we leaked the news. You know what I mean? Like,
oh, okay.
Yeah, we did that.
Got you. For the fans or?
No, well, really at that point, it was more of a just an awareness thing. Like, to
got
let
you.
People know that there was some injustice being done.
Yeah.
And we needed to shed light on, basically.
Mm-hmm.
Using my platform, it was just a good opportunity to let people know what's happening.
One thing I will say is that you definitely did come back with like a Jamaican kind of dance or kind of vibe. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You deserve it. I remember I spun that on my show. Big tune.
Thank
you know
you.
What I mean?
Appreciate it.
How did that tune come about?
So You Deserve It came out while I was still in Jamaica.
Mm-hmm.
It's produced by Deanie Boy. Me and Deanie had been connecting for a while.
And Deanie Boy is a producer, of course, out there.
No, he's here.
Oh, he's from here?
Yeah,
oh,
from
okay.
He's from Peckham.
Oh, sick.
Yeah, he's from Peckham. A lot of people may not know that, but
mm-hmm.
Me and Deanie connected. We never knew each other before I left, but once we connected, everything just made sense. We went to the same primary school in Peckham. Do you know what I mean? Everything just connected. He produced You Deserve It. It was a good moment for me because I felt like at that point when I was in Yard, I don't know, like, I knew the time was approaching that I should be going back to England. But in that moment, music was the only thing that I needed to, that I could use to cope, basically, with everything. So,
like your escape.
Yeah, it was my escape. So making a song that could uplift me and uplift people, it was a good moment.
It's a big tune.
Thank you.
Definitely. Are you going to be making more tunes like that?
Well, like You Deserve It?
Yeah.
Yeah, we got them, man.
Yeah.
We got them. I mean, Wagwan with Western, it's not exactly like You Deserve It, but
it's
same.
Kinda, yeah, it's the same. Yeah.
Yeah, so that should kind of give you an example.
Big tune.
Like, yeah, we got. Thank you. We got loads of those.
But I do like it when you drop, you know, Trench Baby and 10 on it. Talk to me about Trench Baby, you know, because that beat is cold as well, by the way.
Deanie Boy as well.
Ah, Deanie Boy, shout out Deanie Boy, you know. So yeah, talk to me about Trench Baby.
Trench Baby, do you know what? Trench Baby was like one of my most organic songs. Like, it's one of my favorite songs I've ever done.
Mm-hmm.
And it's because how it came about, it was just, I was just cleaning the yard on a Sunday. Deanie sent the rhythm maybe, when did you say, like the day before or something?
Oh, you're in the building?
Yeah.
Oh, Deanie, hi. I didn't know that, hi.
Yeah, so he might have sent it on the Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
And I do the Sunday house cleaning thing.
Okay.
So, Sunday, up and running, cleaning mm-hmm. the yard and that, letting the beat run. But usually I'll clean the yard and then I'm on Instagram live at the same time.
I like the way how you say you clean the yard, you know.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
Take note, people. Yeah, you must clean. You know what I mean?
So we was running, I was running the instrumental and I was just like freestyling and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
And based on the reaction, people were saying like, yo, we need this as a song.
Yeah.
And like at first, like I'm just messing around innit, so I'm not really taking it like,
too seriously.
Yeah, I'm fucking about. Do you know what I mean? So after seeing the reaction, basically, like after I got off the live, but I'd saved it. So I'm going back through it. I'm seeing like, rah, they're really messing with this.
Mm-hmm.
I just went downstairs into the studio and then just recorded it. And then it was out maybe in the next couple of days. And then we started the Trench Baby Challenge and then that was going viral.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it was mad. So Trench Babies, and then separate to that, just the core of that song, like,
mm-hmm.
like as a quick black story, the outro on that song was done by two of my aunts.
Okay.
Right. Now, my family, I grew up in a family like war is just our thing,
mm-hmm.
even if it's amongst each other.
Right.
So. There's family,
but it's still love.
Yeah, it's love. So still it's love. Like it's there's no in between. It's either we're warring or we love each other.
Yeah,
one or two or whatever. But so I've got family members that haven't spoken in years and all of that type of stuff. So my uncle died like last year.
Rest in peace.
And when he died, basically, they made a family group chat. Mm-hmm. So this is the first time bare people are in there chatting that ain't spoken in years. Basically, so. Yeah. Those were voice notes basically that were sent from my aunts in the group,
in the group
basically.
Chat.
Yeah, because it got to like talking about me when I was growing up and what.
Very organic.
And how I was.
Yeah.
Yeah, basically. So.
Yeah.
Yeah, very sentimental record. Too.
Love that. Trench Baby. What is the raving scene like in Jamaica? Because you know when I think of Jamaica, I think of like Pasa Pasa, like back in the day. Do you know what I mean? Wild. Like.
Do you know what? Honestly speaking, and you lot could take this as somebody that was living there for five years, not all dances are like that.
Oh, really?
Yeah, no, it's not all like that. You see, like, the perception that they have of, like, yardies, like, raw, like, they'll just go in a tree and do a mantle and jump. Yeah, that's the minority.
Got you.
The whole island ain't like that.
Yeah.
More time, if you think about it, when you're watching Pasa Pasa and that, it's a group of people. But the dance is still
there. But the dance is, you're right.
You know what I mean? But the focus is on them. Yeah. So it seems like raw.
But for me, that was like my first proper insight to like.
Yeah, no, that exists. Like even
that was years ago.
No, but it still exists. It still exists. But obviously, like there's social media now, isn't it? So
that's true.
So not everybody wants to be.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, like there's some people that like grew up and aspire to be like a famous dancer in yard. Like that's a lot of children's dreams out there. Do you know what I mean?
Oh, cool.
Which is something that I think. Maybe no one's spoken about. And as I'm saying it now, I think somebody, you lot could take this idea or I'll execute it. Someone should actually do a movie based on the dance or a documentary based on the dance culture in Jamaica. Because
Literally.
Rash.
Jamaicans are very creative, I must say.
Serious. Like, I don't understand why that actually, if that's been done, someone put me on. But
when you think about old school, like our raving scene,
it
was pretty much about Jamaican culture.
Yeah.
Everything was like, you know, Willy Bounce or Wacky Dip or,
exactly. So really and truly, I think, I think the dancing aspect is definitely a serious thing out there. The dance.
Do they play like UK music and some, I know American probably.
Some UK. So maybe just before I left, they started playing, like Hurting Me had come out. So they tapped into Steph, but again, it's French.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? So it's
more like American.
Yeah, they were more, but since I've left, I know that they've tapped in a lot more. since I've UK left. Yeah, they've tapped in a lot more since. And obviously, like, you have artists like Millions that's flying there.
Yeah.
And connecting dots out there while he's out there. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then you have people that's on the ground, like Odessa. Loads of different people that are helping to bridge the gap.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So when UK artists get out there, there's a platform that's laid for them to, do you know what I mean? It's cool now.
Like, yeah,
you're
going
out there and saying you're a UK rapper. It's holding the weight, like saying you're a US rapper.
Yeah. Oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Times are changing.
Yeah, we're there now.
Times
are
changing. Yeah. Yes. Are you going to be giving us like more visuals out in Jamaica?
Yeah, so that was the plan. I was supposed to be in Yard from January the 3rd. Mm-hmm. I would have probably still been there now.
Okay.
Just working and shooting, basically. So we do have a few songs that are coming out this year that realistically the visuals need to be in Yard.
Yeah.
So we just open that, you get me? Like everything clear up and then we're good to go. And then we got to shoot the documentary. Well, we're shooting the documentary anyway, so.
So you're shooting a documentary?
Yeah, right now you're in it.
Where the camera at?
Oh. You don't worry about that. Oh.
Okay, so you're putting out a documentry.
Yeah.
Coming out this year.
We're working on it.
Yeah, okay. Trying to get an exclusive. Yeah. Okay, cool. Had you not gone to Jamaica, what artist do you think you would have become?
I can't really speak on the type of artist I would have become. I can more speak on the person I would have become.
And okay.
I would have been a person who wasn't aware of where I was from as fully as I now am. Do you know what I mean? It's like, I was never confused about my culture and my identity. Like, I know I'm not British. Like, I've never looked in the mirror and thought.
But I mean, this is your home.
Yeah, nah, you know, but I mean, that's what I'm saying. It's like, I don't know. It's, yeah, for me, it's like, I've always been aware of my culture. So, yeah, I don't know.
Speaking of your culture, who makes better jerk chicken?
Then who and who?
Jamaica or
UK? Of who? Jamaica.
Yeah.
You mean Jamaica? You mean like
old? Who makes better jerk chicken?
No, you've got to say, no. If you're gonna do a like, you got to say
Jamaicans in the UK.
Ochi. No. It's Ochi or Mobe or Kingston. It's
See,
all
I,
in,
I don't know.
That's what I'm saying.
I just know about jerk.
It's,
you know what I mean?
The jerk chicken. If you're gonna do that comparison, it's.
So who makes it? Where makes the best jerk then in Jamaica?
That's a better question.
Okay,
You can't even put England in there.
Okay.
You can't even do it.
I like jerk here though.
To be fair, and I'm going to shout them out. What are they called? Is it Good Life? Good Life. Yeah, there's one spot in Croydon.
Okay.
Yeah, black owned business. So I'm shouting it out and I don't need no money for that. Good Life, Jerk Centre. Is that it? Yeah, you lot hit them.
They make
up
a good jerk.
Best
jerk
I've had in the UK.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like, definitely. So you lot go and hit them up.
So what part in Jamaica? Because you see, one day if I go, I must know.
It's
you
definitely going to be Kingston.
Okay.
Specifically, Red Hills Road, where I'm from.
Mm-hmm.
Specifically.
Specifically there,
Yeah, specifically.
Okay.
Yeah, you get to Yard and you say you want jerk chicken, they're going to tell you Red Hills Road. And if they tell you anywhere else, then the jerk
second best.
The jerk man's probably related to them or something.
We are going to take it back to 2011.
Okay.
Talk about pain.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah? Talk to me about that, because that's quite deep.
Talk about pain for me. Rash could probably, like, confirm, but in a time when I believe, like, I got attention in the UK scene from early for a couple different reasons, but one of the reasons was definitely because of how vulnerable I was within my records. When everyone was just chatting grease, like, I tapped in at a time where I could tell you my mum's in prison right now and you ain't never heard a rapper say that.
Yeah, you was definitely a storyteller.
Yeah, do you know what I mean? Like, I've tapped in at a time where I'm saying, like, yeah, like, I've been evicted. It's not like no one said this before, but in that moment
and
specifically,
that no one was talking.
Everyone's nice. Like that, no one's going through any pain. Do you know what I mean? Like, in that moment. So it was all trying to make wavy music and all of that type of stuff. So when I did talk about pain, I wanted to kind of put the title to let you know straight away what it was about.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Obviously, Link Up TV, Rashid followed and shot that
big
video
up
there.
Rashid.
Yeah. Rash came to the family house and
filmed
everybody in there. And you know what I mean? So talk about pain for me. It's also another thing to highlight is talk about pain is on a dancehall rhythm. This is a dancehall rhythm from then.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, this is did like you'll find Movado songs on this same rhythm.
Okay.
You see what I'm trying to show okay. you? So it was also a time of like, because after we, me and my lot, mm-hmm. pioneered the rapping on dancehall beats.
Okay, yeah.
Because we're not going to go. Yeah, after we did that, yeah. it was all like, it was up tempo, so it was like the
you definitely bring the up tempo yeah, vibe so, back
so,
in the day.
So this yeah. now was almost like the first time someone's doing it on like a real talk conscious type of way. That's what Talk About Pain is. Do you know what I mean? But yeah. no one really clocked it fully, do you know what I mean? But really that's a dancehall rhythm.
Sick. Yeah. And it seems like you saying that it kind of makes sense because at that time that's what Jamaican artists were doing, like they yeah. even now they just jump on the same kind
yeah,
of rhythm.
Yeah, yeah,
so
yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah. If you
yeah.
know, you know.
Yeah,
as you
exactly,
said,
exactly.
Sick. When you hear this tune,
yeah,
what would you tell the younger you?
That's a good question. When I hear Talk About Pain, what would I tell the younger me? You're headed in the right direction musically. Yeah, 100%. Yeah, 100%.
Nice. Did you ever feel the love from the scene coming back?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, 100%.
Felt embraced,
yeah,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, man, first 24 hours, mad.
Yeah, talk to me about that. How was it though, like the first 24 hours?
Do you know what it is? It was weird because when I announced, I had already been in the UK hiding for 7 months.
You was hiding for 7 months?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What do you mean hide? As in just like off the radar? Like
yeah.
no one didn't know? Yeah.
Everyone thought I was still in yard.
Okay. Oh, so, well, so even like your close friends? And
yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh,
like a couple
okay.
of them in the building now didn't know straight away.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, like so I returned in March 2019.
Yeah.
I announced I was back in October 2019. So for that time frame there.
Just doing your own thing.
Well, I couldn't really do much because obviously if anyone see me, the news would leak.
Right, right.
So I was like really just spending time with family. It had been 5 years at the time. So I was spending time with family and we was really like planning on how to get the rollout right.
Yeah.
Like you don't really get a second chance in this thing. Do you know what I mean? Like you don't really get a second chance in this thing. So I didn't want to take that for granted. It wasn't a... fresh home champagne pour over my head thing. Nah.
It's let's get to business.
Yeah, like this is a serious, now. Serious yep. situation. Like what I've just left. Mm-hmm. Trust me.
Certain people couldn't even
yeah,
handle that.
Yeah, it's different.
It's
different. You're not
yep.
going to just chuck me on one of them local vlogs today and then that's it.
Right.
You know what I mean? So we had to spend, we spent 7 months.
But that's really smart. Because as you said, some people are so impulsive where they would do that.
Yeah, do you know what it is? For me, and you have to imagine, like, I really wanted to do that.
Yeah,
do you
know 5 years.
Yeah, like,
in a different
the old
country.
Me, you see the Cashh that went to Jamaica? Mm-hmm. If it was him that was returning, because it's not him, so I'm a different person.
Right. Would have been the extravagant.
He would have been on, like, yo, get Link Up TV at the airport.
Right.
You get me? Right now, let's do it. Right yeah. now, you get me? But I'm more calculated now and try to make sure that we find a fine balance of being calculated, but also being organic.
Right, right. Take note, you know, take note, people, take note. Pounds and dollars, right? Before we get into speaking about that, I just want to know, what was it like kind of adapting to the new sound from the UK scene? You know what I mean? Because when you was rapping, it was strictly rap.
Yeah,
you know what
yeah,
I mean? We
yeah.
didn't have any different kind of sound.
Yeah,
now
yeah.
we've got like an Afrobeat
yeah.
with like the dancehall as well
yeah.
as like drill.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? How did that, like, how did you adapt
dance
to that?
Dancehall and reggae is in all of them. So it was
right.
very easy.
Okay.
I was looking at it like a blessing from God. Imagine me in yard mm-hmm. hearing people rap on like doing
like
songs
upbeat.
On like Afro beats type.
Right.
I'm like, yo, that's my lane. So I hear you, but when I do it,
right.
it's going to be different.
Mad thing.
So please stay on that.
Yeah.
Let me just get over there and you know what I'm saying?
But
so
yeah.
Yeah, for me, it wasn't difficult at all because dancehall and reggae music is running through every single one of them.
Right,
you know what
that's
I mean?
True.
Like drill, that. If you slow that down, that's.
Right, right, yeah.
You get what I'm saying? So it's there already. It's there already.
I like how you broke that down, you know. Do you think it's harder for you to connect to the younger generation? Because again, when you was doing rap, it was more for our generation.
Yeah, yeah,
you know what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
Now it's like, you got the younger generation that's like,
yeah,
you know what
yeah.
I mean, doing their thing.
I don't think it's harder for me to I think it would it will be hard or feel difficult if I'm trying to do that.
Okay.
But there's no point in me doing that. Do you know what I mean?
It's just kind of doing your own thing.
Yeah, like my thing is they're going to tap in, but they're going to tap in from what I do and how I do it.
Right.
You get me? You're not going to see me doing them mad local things on, do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
Like I get it. I'm not one of them that don't want to move with the time. Hence why I'm doing drill and Jonas, I'm trying to show you. But like for me, you have to bear in mind, there's a lot of different ways to sell out. Right?
Mm-hmm.
For me, if you're versatile as an artist, if you're somebody who can make different types of music,
you're not a sellout.
You can't be a sellout.
You can't be a sellout.
How can you be? Yeah. How can you know that you can build a glass from scratch and just don't use that talent?
It's true. It does not make no sense.
Like, how can you know you can build a glass from scratch, but you're going to spend the whole of your life drinking water that is?
Yeah.
From the pipe.
Yeah.
No point.
But a lot of rappers are not versatile like that.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean? And God bless them too.
Yeah, that's true. Because there are certain rappers that, like, for example, if they're genre is like rap,
yeah,
and they jump on a grime beat, it just sounds
it's not
off,
the same. Yeah,
you know
no, that's
but
facts.
Then there's certain ones like yourself, yeah, that can facts. Jump on like a dance or and do like a drill, you know what I mean?
I hear you. I agree with
yeah.
you.
I want to know, like, you know, with your track Pounds and Dollars,
yeah,
with Millions,
yeah,
you spoke about him briefly earlier. How did that collaboration come about?
Do you know what, for me, like, when I was watching how Migs was operating and like slowly starting to fly the flag for Yard,
yeah,
automatically I gravitated to that, you understand, because in terms
it's
of
your country,
yeah, but it's he was different with what he was doing, or should I say what he is doing. Like, he weren't just jumping on Yard rhythms. You see, you know, when you're a real person and somebody else brings someone in the room who they define as a real person, you can know that person isn't real.
That's true.
You see what I'm trying to show you? So with Migs, it's little fine details. Like, he went Yard to shoot the YPRE video. Enough people go to Yard to shoot the YPRE video. But you see the way he tied his bandana?
Yeah.
Automatically,
you just
stamp
know.
Of approval.
Right, okay.
Yeah, automatically stamp of approval because...
Why? What?
Because you're not going to go on any estate in England, in London, in anywhere, and see any of the youths tie their bandana that way.
Okay.
With like, he's in Yard, he could have gone out there, big drip. He's just in his marina. You see what I'm trying to show you?
Yeah.
So,
it's just all about the music.
Yeah, it's the music, but it's also how authentic he's representing the culture.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Like, mm-hmm. he didn't fly out there and had like crazy different outfits. And he, imagine him just shooting in the block where he's from or whatever out there. And he's the only one looking lit.
Yeah.
He blended right in, do you know what I'm trying to say? So that gravitated me to him automatically. And then we connected. And then, once we connected, we realized like there's connections within the streets, like outside of the music industry, you get me? So when we linked, naturally, we're chopping it up on the phone and that. And he's young as well. So obviously, he grew up knowing man's music. So there was just that natural
kind of connection.
Conversation. Like, bro, I'm finally getting to chat to my man. Like, there's questions that, like, I don't know if I'm ever gonna meet Cash, so I don't know if I need to ask him that.
Right.
But now I finally met him.
It's like, why not?
Like, bro, do you know what I mean? So
break the ice.
Kind of where the conversation went. You get me? Like, you wanted to know what it was like in Yard and how man survive out there.
Yeah.
You get me? Because the more time they go out there for like a couple weeks or a couple months or whatever, and they're deading to come back to England.
Because
it's like Yard gives you that kind of vibe. You can be out there and then after a while it's just like, you know what, time to go back home. Still, I had that feeling and had to stay there for 5 years. You see what I'm trying to show you? So it's like, yo, how did that work for you? It just sparks natural.
And I know it's going to sound so crazy, but everything does happen for a reason.
I know, 100%.
And as you said, like...
That don't even sound crazy. Let me just tell you that. Yeah, it doesn't sound crazy.
Definitely like at the end of your tunnel. Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, you're here now.
Yeah.
Speaking of, obviously, Pounds and Dollars, we're going to go into a game.
Mm-hmm.
And it's called Name That Currency. Yeah, you done it to yourself, you know.
God.
So I'm going to simply name a country. and give you free options. So I'm being really nice. Do you know what I mean? Because I'm just giving you the country.
That's nice. That's nice.
So I'm going to give you free options and you're going to guess which currency is correct that they use, right?
Cool.
So for example, this is really easy, but the rest of them are going to be hard. But I'm just, you know what I mean? Real easy. The UK. A, euro. B, dollars. C, pound sterling.
Okay, cool. Pound sterling.
Pound sterling. Ding, 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 ding. Cool. Yeah, you ready?
I was hoping that was going to be the first. Couldn't we class that as one? No. So I could get a local one in there.
That's a warm up. Yeah? Warming you up. Are you ready?
Go true.
Yeah? Japan. A, yen. B, one. C, konnichiwa.
Yen.
Ding, 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 ding.
Come on, man. Akemi and them gal. If you know Akemi and them gal, Midnight by Sister Soldier.
Oh gosh.
Trust me. Someone knows.
Okay, so Turkey. A, real. B, lira. C, peso.
Say that again.
Do we get to say it again, Rashid? Oh, okay, you're lucky, you know.
Only right.
Oh, okay. So Turkey, A, real. B, lira, or C, peso?
First of all, big up all of my Achilles them in Dalaman. Big up all of my Achilles them in Istanbul. Big up all of my Achilles them in Fethiye. Yeah? The currency
right
that you're looking for is...
Yeah?
Minuetina, just repeat it. Just repeat it one. It's the last one.
Rashid!
You have to run
again.
That.
Again. All right.
It's
A... Go on. Real.
Yeah.
B, lira.
Lira.
But technically, are we going to give that to him?
We have to. Okay. I was trying to give big ups at the same time. I was working on the big up speech, so I weren't concentrating.
Right, right. Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah. I see you, Cashh. Yeah. Brazil. A, rupee. Yeah. B, Nakfa. Or C, real.
What did you say? Rupee.
Rupee.
Is that what you said?
Yeah.
Yeah, go true.
Incorrect.
Yeah, I knew that was incorrect. What is it? Rupa?
Nah.
What?
It's C. Real.
Real.
It's actually called Brazilian real, but I didn't want to put Brazilian
if
in there
you
because
said Brazilian
then,
real,
then
I would have known
bait.
That was the one.
No,
really,
it's a bit bait. You know what I mean?
Me.
I had to trick you.
Yeah, you tried to trick me. I knew it as Brazilian real, not just real.
I had to trick you. Okay, Nigeria. Naira. Shilling or Chedi?
All right, so I want to see something. You see the green and white?
Yeah.
Big up my Nigerian people. Yeah. Them. But said that, you see the Jamaican flag?
Yep.
All right. The answer you're looking for is Naira.
Yeah.
Here is. You can't just reach on this platform and just answer normally. I'm a yard man. I got to answer with style.
Right.
You understand?
Okay.
All right.
I hope you got you lot see that, yeah?
Nah, they got that.
Russia.
Yeah.
A. Burr. Yeah. C. Yeah. Ruble.
Yeah.
Or C. No, sorry. B. Ruble. Mm-hmm. Or C. Ringgit.
Ruble.
But did you know Burr is actually a real currency?
I didn't. I'm never going to lie.
Yeah, Ethiopian.
Mad.
Yeah, my next door neighbors. Ding, ding, ding.
Mad.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, you're with Live and Direct with Cashh. What's your name and where are you from?
Tristan from Cardiff.
Hi, well, big up Cardiff.
Big up Cardiff.
Big up. First of all, I just want to say, big up. We're happy to have you back on the scene, man.
Thank you, brother. Much appreciated.
No worries. And then, secondly, I just wanted to ask, while she was out in Jamaica and that, was you able to, connect or link up with any of the local artists out there?
Yeah, for sure. I connected with artists without letting them know that I'm an artist.
Okay.
Yeah, so the relationship could be organic and it wouldn't be some, I'm an artist trying to beg a feature thing. Like, I connected with them in the streets first.
Yeah.
And secondly, if you was able to link up with any artist from Jamaica, any future project or not, who would you pick?
What do you mean in terms of features?
Yeah.
Popcorn.
Yeah, nah, yeah, fair.
Yeah.
What about a female artist out there?
Female artist, Coffee.
Coffee.
Yeah.
Nice. Thank you.
All right, respect.
Bye.
Respect, bro.
Hello?
Hi, you're with Live and Direct with Cashh.
Oh, hey, hey, hey. So, remember when Cashh did your Behind Barz?
Yeah.
Like, which was over, like 10 years ago, if I'm correct?
Is he right around that? Yeah, around that. My thing.
Yeah, so, like, what kind of headspace were you? Because I remember, like, them, like, because I remember I was in school them days, and it, like, people were going crazy for that. Because those days, like, Facebook was kind of hot.
Yeah.
And I remember everyone was talking about that, your freestyle. It was just, even though there was so much pain, but there was so much, and we could literally feel it. Even in your facial expression, you could just feel, like, every emotion. Like, so I wanted to know, like, what made you, like, what's the word for it? Like, what was your headspace, and what was kind of going on for you to kind of eject so much emotion, so much pain that people could, like, feel it? Do you know what I'm saying?
Good question, bro. Literally everything that I said in the freestyle, like, even when I'm saying I've been nicked for a next man's crime on my life, and I mentioned his name to the police, like, these are things that are actively going on. Do you know what I mean? These are things that still affects me later on in life now. Do you know what I mean? So when I'm putting that in a freestyle, It's real and raw emotions that are going through. You get me? So what you lot are seeing is everything that was just, do you know what I mean? Like, shout out my cousin Trim. Me and Trim was doing a night shift one time. And you get me? He was out the car going to do his thing, and I was in the car with the instrumental on repeat. And I wrote it. And then, we connected with Link Up TV and Rashid and made that happen. And again, I think because I was being so vulnerable, do you know what? Yeah. I'll be honest with you, bro. You see me, I'm a man. If you ever hear, like, Cashh gets exposed or anything like that, like, I don't know what no one can expose me for. Do you know what I mean? And that was one of my things, you know, like, similar to, like, Eminem in 8 Mile, like, I'm going to tell you everything
about myself.
Yeah,
first,
about myself. You can't tell me nothing. I've been robbed. I've told man I've almost been stabbed. I've told, do you understand? Just like I've told them on the offense. I've told them everything I've done on the offense, but we're not just out here in the streets on the offense all the time.
Right.
Sometimes we're on the defense, and I try to make sure that I portrayed that from the jump. Do you know what I mean? So, that was everything that I was going through at the time.
It shows your character.
Yeah.
Like, how did you feel, like, how people took it in?
It's crazy. I'm gonna tell you, like, and I said it the other day to Trim. I remember that song was the first time that I saw the effects of me being vulnerable.
Right.
Like, imagine, like, the line that, like, I'd gone to this girl's house. She's invited me around family settings, like backyard, families are out there, boom, bum, 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 bum. And then I can't remember, like, her mum said something to me and I must have smiled. And she was like, wait, are you just smiling back to blend in? I was like, wait. I was like, oh shit, like, bro, like, I crumbled on the spot.
What can you say, really?
God, I weren't expecting her to know my lyrics, you know what I mean? Like, so I crumbled. So yeah, it was like everyone receiving it, like it was a moment for me, man. I think a lot of moments in my career, like, I've always kind of ran past them. Do you know what I mean? It's like, yeah, this is happening now, but what am I on next? But that one I couldn't help.
Yeah.
That one that was present, I knew what was happening with that. Do you know what I mean? Like,
sick.
No, definitely. Also, I'm still taking it back to, like, old school.
Yeah.
But remember when you made a tune, like, I Didn't Mean It?
Yeah.
Like, this was, like, roughly around 10 years.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Because obviously that was based on, like, a real life.
Real, like, life story,
so,
man.
Yeah, real life. So, like, sadness. How was, like, so it's kind of two questions in one, yeah? So it's, like, how was your life, like, during them times as well? But, and what were you listening to? Because that was, like, when you think about that story, it's kind of, it was such a sticky situation, if I could say, at the best, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Do you know what? Do you want me to be totally honest with you?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to break it down. For people who don't know, I Didn't Mean It, the concept of the song is basically me talking about I got a brethren and he's telling me about his girl, like this new girl that he has. And basically, he don't normally get girl like that. So for him, this is a moment. I'm happy for my guy. You see me? So he introduces me to her. One day she forwards to the yard. And I know her.
Oh,
you see what I'm trying to
like
show
that.
You?
Okay.
So I'm saying I didn't mean it.
Oh God!
I'd be lying if I said I didn't beat it.
Oh God!
Yeah, but it's real life stories. You see what I'm trying to show you? Yeah. So, but I didn't. Obviously, when he's telling me about this girl, like this is history. Like I didn't know this was the girl he was chatting about.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? Like
just
this is history.
Happened. Yeah.
So obviously, naturally, it's my brethren.
You're gonna tell him.
I'm saying, bro, because. Awkward East Ended moment when he's introducing us and it's like
her.
It's like rah, she's trying to go on like we don't know each other. You know what I'm trying to show? Like, she's trying to go on like and she's putting me in the spot because I know he loves her. Do you know what I mean?
Oh,
so I'm
I
saying,
love
oh, I'm saying rah.
Oh, God.
You get me? So boom, I've told him, I'm saying, bro, bong bang 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 bang. He's flipped on me. Nah, you had to know. I'm saying, how could I know? This is before
you even met her.
Yeah.
So how, yeah,
but,
I'm telling you
but
now.
I'm telling
yeah.
you, he's not a man that's in that world
right.
normally, you see me?
Yeah.
So, yeah, like he started talking light, like he was talking light. And I was thinking, you know what, rather than I punch you up, I'm just going to do a song.
Do a song, yeah.
But I respect you enough to change your name to Kai. So it's not his real, his real name's not Kai.
Okay, big up Kai though.
Yeah, big
my
up
God.
Kai, big yeah. up Kai. Nah, Kai cool man.
Kai,
Kai
cool.
Kai good, you.
Thank you. Oh,
you say, bro?
What are you gonna say, sir?
No, yeah. Have you got another question or?
Oh yeah. I got a few.
Okay, just one,
so like,
one more.
So, in terms of the cast, like your transition in terms of like. Obviously, we've been speaking about like old school, kind of your old school tracks, which are almost like literally a decade old. Like, how would you say, like, how have you changed as a person? How have people changed from you? Because I remember when you made a tune, like, in terms of like called Conversation with Cashh.
Yeah.
Conversation with Cashh, where you're just talking about how, like, you've elevated in life and now people are trying to come into your life and try to, like, almost act like you owe them something, innit?
Yeah.
So it's like from talking about tunes that almost literally like we say that like almost a decade ago to now, like how have you as a person transitioned and also how have people kind of acted around you, do you know what I'm saying?
Do you know what? Good question, bro. I think because by the time I did Conversation with Cashh, like I was fresh out the streets, so I didn't know how to handle it. And plus, like, you have to bear in mind, I'm young at this point. Do you know what I mean? I'm still a kid, really. I'm thinking I'm a big man, but really, I'm a kid.
Yeah.
So I'm dealing with life, but I'm not dealing with it properly. Or not even properly, but I don't know how to deal
with
it. Yeah, I'm just dealing with it
yeah.
how I can. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't know how to handle, like people randomly, like
coming
like,
up raw, to you.
Yeah, like, raw.
The whole picture
Yeah, man,
thing.
I grew up with my man.
Right.
Like, yeah, man, like, all of a sudden, it's pally pally. I didn't know how to really deal with that. The transition, I'd say, is right now, there is no dealing with that because you don't even have my number.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, real talk, if you didn't have my +1876, you don't have my +44. And if you don't know what that means, that says everything.
Did you get that?
Yeah, I got that.
Okay, thank you for calling in.
Respect, bro. Good questions.
Yeah, love.
Sure. So soon we are going to be getting into your live performance.
Yeah.
Of Pounds and Dollars.
Yeah.
I just want to ask, like, for your fans, what can we expect? So you've got the documentary coming out soon. Mm-hmm. You've got projects.
Yeah.
What else?
What I'd say is, if you're a fan of Cashtastic, if you're a fan of Cashh, this that I'm about to do, this that I've already started doing, I've never done it before. Like what I'm about to do, I'm very excited for, because
nice.
I feel like I've never really like. I feel like just when I was on my path to do what I was gonna do, I ended up getting sent back to yard. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I don't know, man. I feel like
because you was literally at your peak.
Yeah, I'm right
like,
there.
Right
do you know what I mean?
And so then boom.
Yeah. So do you know what it is? It's like I was. Imagine when I was right there.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't think I was right there.
Yeah.
Like, now I can say I was right there. But in that moment, I'm just really going through.
Yeah.
Like, Crepton Conan had just gone through. Really, yes. And I'm the next one to go. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I knew in that sense, like, raw, things soon, are lined up.
Right.
But I didn't know how far the game could take us, really, at that point.
Yeah.
I'm now very aware of what's about to happen. Mm-hmm. God willing. Do you know what I mean? Like, yeah. I could tell you the date it's going to happen.
Good.
Yeah.
And I feel like that's pretty much based on, like, your time in Jamaica.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Yeah. It's the time that, listen, like, I spent them 5 years sharpening my tools. Like, yeah. I weren't, like, it was very deliberate of me to not try to be the hottest artist in the UK while being in Jamaica. All I wanted to do is just make sure that when I was dropping music, it was just so that
you're relevant. Like, yeah, you're there,
every
like
now and then you go on Link Up TV, you'll see a new video
and
from Cashh.
And especially movie with the intent to.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
You understand? Yeah. Like, that was really what the intentions were, because I knew to get people to care when you're coming from cold turkey is harder than
this is.
Like, yeah, see my, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. And plus, after a while, after somebody sees you every now and then, every time,
yeah,
it's like, but he hasn't given up though.
You know,
like,
I mean,
he's still doing his thing.
Doing his
so
thing.
When you hear that I've returned, it's like, raw, like, you're happy for me without even knowing me.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? So for me, I'm just really excited because, like, God wills it and God's been willing. Like, everything that we
it's happening. Definitely.
And I feel like, yeah, only God can stop it. Do you know what I mean? I feel like right now, there's no blackballing. There's nobody that can take this away from our moment right now. Like, what's and it's very early. That's what
And what's written for you will always be
it's there already. And I'm very confident in the music that's coming. Like, I can honestly say it's the best music I've ever made. I know other artists say that, but I could play you play you those and then play you the
but
equivalent
I feel like
to
you
those.
Should be like that. Do you know
yeah,
what I mean? You
like,
should be
yeah,
confident and, you know, sure of yourself.
Listen,
and your
I'm
music.
I'm so like, it's almost overwhelming because like, this sitting down with you right now, I didn't know it was going to be this setup, but I envisioned this while I was in yard.
Right.
Like, I imagined, like, raw, yeah. And then after I drop a single, I'm going to do some sort. I don't know what the run's going to be.
Right.
This would have been a radio run.
It's true.
I never knew COVID would have happened. Mm-hmm. So it would have ended up being this. But I envisioned this.
Yeah.
So I know, do you know what I'm trying to show you? Mm-hmm. Like, the blind faith is ridiculous.
Yeah.
So, yeah, man, I'm excited.
Yes,
I hope that
Cashh.
Explains I'm just looking
forward to the documentary, you know what I mean? Because we couldn't really talk too much about Jamaica.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
You know what I mean?
That's why. I hope that makes sense now to you. Yeah, that's
oh,
what
yeah,
it is.
Yeah, yeah.
And then
I'm
in terms of like backstory, for anyone who doesn't know, Link Up TV flew to Jamaica while I was there and actually filmed a documentary while I was still in it.
Okay.
It's called Sankofa. Yeah, Sankofa. Sorry, I've gone Ghana now and they've told me how to pronounce it properly. Yeah, we got my brother there.
Yes,
yeah?
Yes.
Yeah, the documentary is called Sankofa. Probably just type Cashh documentary. Cashh spelled with two H's and you'll see it. So that you're going to see. I'd advise you to go and watch that before you probably watch the next documentary because that one, I'm live, I'm still in it. I don't know when I'm coming back to England.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
That's
you.
So, but you're back.
Yeah,
but
I'm here.
Good old
here.
London town.
Yeah.
We're going to get into a live PA.
Yeah.
You are going to be performing Pounds and Dollars.
Yeah, yeah.
You ready?
Ready. Let me get some volume. Yeah. Volume. Yeah, everybody, if you're tuning in right now, one thing I want you not to do, just turn it up. Are you ready? What we spending? Pounds and dollars. Put 50 in the shooter's hands, call that a pinky promise. I'm a trench babies, I grew up in the mud with the brothers. We don't take treason lightly, you might get burned for pretending to love her. Look, she said her first favourite thing to do is fuck. Second favourite thing to do is eat. Third favourite thing to do is travel. Food, orgasm and duty free. Man are beefing on Insta Live. All of them ting they're new to me. You know how the ting go usually. Bye. Look, 18 carrots, mashed peas, beef, shepherd's pie in these streets. Just touched down in London.
Alright, can we get a pull up? Can we get a pull up?
Yeah. I need the money you owe.
Order
I'm gonna
that.
Repatriate. So I'm gonna need the money you. Hear that, Dini boy, big up yourself. Dini boy in the production again, hear that? Aye, what we spending? Pounds and dollars. Put 50 in the shooter's hands, call that a pinky promise. I'm a trench baby, grew up in the mud with the brothers. We don't take treason lightly, you might get fun for pretending to love us. She
said, her first favourite thing to do is fuck. Second favourite thing to do is eat. First favourite thing to do is travel. Food, orgasm and duty free. Man a beefing on Insta Live. All of them ting they're new to me. You know how the ting go usually. Blight, blight. 18 carrots, mashed peas, beef, shepherd's pie in these streets. Just touched down in a London. I was just chilling on the beach. The witness say that the shooter's light skin, but he's black like me. Why think the man then bleach? Old school, I was in OT, hands on 28 grams on me. Yeah, new school and I'm on OG beaches, probably got sand on me. Yeah, I was just doing up nature, never had all of these brands on me. Still a sweet one jumped on a virgin flat so that she could put hands on me. Yeah, hear that? Bomba clap, what we spending, huh? Pounds and dollars. Put 50 in the shooter's hands, call that pinky promise. Trench babies, grew up in the mud with a...
What should we do, millions is verse? Alright, we're gonna do millions is verse. Hear my accent.
Send me your talk lock, get chip up as soon as I slip up in the fire.
Right. It digs in the car.
I see man get stick up, for chain get give up for thinking he's hard. Anytime the M16 get lift up, man, mine, I ain't a regular con. Ain't got no hand sanitizer, wash up the W with rum overproof. It's been a long time since I seen them ban true say, but it's well overdue. Heard a funny you say something out of turn, man, man must be smoking a stove for truth. Brother, want move closer to home, old man peas, postpone move. What's the exchange rate, bro? Would it make more sense if I pop it in Holland? And my cousin still scamming in yard like high, say he just won $1,000. I kick back, I watch my young boy shoot like footy ages when this guy is. If the G-boy tries to round this foreign fuck the I'm boxing mothers, huh? Yeah, pounds and dollars. Put 50 in the shooter's hands. Pinky promise, yeah, I'm a trench baby. Drop in the mud with the brothers. We don't take treason lightly, you might get bun for pretending to whip. Winning regardless. Try put my name on the list of the daily departed, but I'm just starting. I don't wanna seem invasive, darling. I'm just asking. Look, how many wiggle and jump and twist did it take to fit all of that arse in? Look, champagne, Cartier glasses, dialogue different when you talk with bosses. Build some apartments, we don't do car theft. Mum said drop them out, cause the energy's off and they're gonna be crossing. Well on, Violate man, are you planning a yard trip? A yard trip? I just go Western Union in the morning. Who spend it? Pounds and dollars. Yeah, put 50 in the shooter's hands, call that a pinky promise. Yeah. I'm a trench baby. Grew up in the mud with the brothers. We don't take treason lightly, you might get bun for pretending to love her. Yeah. Who's spending? Pounds and dollars. 50 in the shooter's hands, cool that a pinky promise. Yeah. Trench babies. Grew up in the mud with the brothers. We don't take treason lightly, you might get bun for pretending to link up TV.
Pounds
done,
and dollars out right now, featuring millions. Yeah. This is live and direct. We are the hub, yeah. Live. Cashh. Tell them your social media.
Follow me on Instagram at the name is Cashh. Cashh is spelt with 2 H's. So for those that don't know as well, like I'd no longer go by the name of Cashtastic.
But you was Cashh, then you went to Cashtastic, then you went to Cashh.
You see you? Round of applause for you.
And
So the name is Cashh on Instagram. Twitter is still Cashtastic Music.
Yep.
Subscribe to the YouTube channel, because you see the YouTube channel is where I'm going to get active. The YouTube channel is at the name is Cashh, same as the Instagram.
Yep.
You see on that YouTube channel,
that's where you get all
listen
the
to
content
me. Listen to
Cashh.
Me. Listen to me.
Right.
You need to go on there and you need to subscribe. I'm not talking to everyone listening. I'm talking to you.
Are you talking to me?
I'm talking to you.
All right, I'm a subscribe still.
Yeah, that one was for you. Okay. Now everyone listening, back to you. Yeah, go subscribe. Yeah, go subscribe to the YouTube channel. The name is Cashh, because I promise you, like, we're very consistent this year. This year we're on the ball. And do you know what it is? I'm a spontaneous human being.
Yeah.
And I feel like I haven't portrayed that in the music industry yet.
And it's coming.
Now, like, literally, I might feel to do something tomorrow night and I'll just film a video and it drops. So you want to subscribe so that you're the first to know what I'm going. You see?
Sick.
Yeah, yeah.
I got you. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes. Big up everyone. Thanks for tuning in.
Thank you. Love.